let's get into what makes his house a dope black movie. What's up, everybody? Welcome to Dope Black Movies. I'm Victor Stiff, a writer and film critic who watches hundreds of movies a year, and my goal for this channel is to help you discover your next favorite movie. Today, I'll be talking about His House, one of the scariest movies to hit Netflix in 2020. His House made its debut last January, where it terrified festival-goers as part of Sundance's Midnight program. The rest of the world had to wait until October to stream it on Netflix, and was it ever worth the wait? His House is an impressive feature debut by the film's writer and director Remi Weekes, who puts an ingenious spin on the classic haunted house premise. His House stars Wunmi and Sope Dirisu as Rial and Bol, two refugees escaping war-torn South Sudan, seeking asylum in England. When the film begins, they're finally being released from a detention center, and the government places them in a rundown council estate where they must remain until their case gets resolved. And right off the bat, they're slapped with all kinds of restrictions. If they get jobs, deported. Miss an appointment, deported. Change residences, you got it, deported. It's a tough situation for two people adjusting to a new country, grieving their daughter's loss, and coping with PTSD. But their prospects go from bad to worse when they realize their house is haunted. As if life wasn't challenging enough for the couple, they're trapped in this situation since they're at the mercy of the system. They can't pack up and leave or ask for a new home without coming off as ungrateful and problematic. That's because some people already view these African asylum seekers as burdens on the system. This is a great setup for a haunting story. How many times have you watched a haunted house movie and thought, why don't these people just leave? The premise is an apt metaphor for the refugees' fear and anxiety living at the mercy of a brutal system. Crafty filmmakers have always used horror flicks as a platform to discuss important social issues. The best directors find ways to sneak scathing social commentaries into their films without seeming like they're finger wagging at the audience. You can't find a better example than John Carpenter's horror sci-fi mashup, They Live. They Live's plot is about a race of alien invaders who secretly rule over humanity, but this movie is really a way for Carpenter to rail against capitalism, deregulation, and Ronald Reagan's impact on conservative politics. Films like They Live, Dawn of the Dead, and Get Out stand out from other horror flicks because they are thrilling movies delivering timely social commentaries that don't feel too preachy. On the surface, His House is a haunted house story, but that's not what it's really about. Weekes uses the supernatural to examine guilt, trauma, masculinity, and how outsiders assimilate into new cultures. The film asks viewers to consider how someone can ever feel safe in a society that doesn't want them there in the first place. Throughout the movie, Rial and Bol must give up pieces of who they are to move forward in their new lives. Their African roots are like anchors, holding them back from being welcomed into their new society. This leads to Bol burning mementos from their old life and refusing to speak in his native tongue, even behind closed doors. These two asylum seekers find themselves in a hopeless situation. To survive, they're forced to constantly prove how well they're assimilating while also concealing their Sudanese culture. This means projecting personas that white people find acceptable while suppressing their blackness. I love the Conjuring franchise, but after 7 years and 7 movies, we've seen all the series' tricks at scaring us. How many more times will we see a door slam shut to trap somebody in a dark room? His House doesn't reinvent the wheel when it comes to scares, but it still delivers jarring segments that don't feel recycled from other films. These creepy sequences work like gangbusters because Weekes establishes such a chilling tone right from the start, and he ratchets it up throughout the entire movie, always keeping you on the edge of your seat. Even when Bol and Rial are outside in safe spaces during the day, you still feel like something terrible is about to happen. Part of this comes from how Weekes finds creative ways to help us relate to the couple's sense of alienation. Scenes taking place in Sudan look warm and sunny, and feature bright colors that establish how the world should look. Scenes shot in England look cold, dreary, and unnatural. They apply a desaturated color palette, making everything look sickly and gray. The effect leaves you feeling like something is off, even when you can't put a finger on why. There are so many cagey elements at work transforming this experience into pure nightmare fuel. The house feels like a living, breathing character thanks to Jacqueline Abraham's stellar production design. Cinematographer Joe Willems captures some horrific images that will sear themselves into your head and stay with you long after the movie ends. There's a debate waging in the film community about the term elevated horror. It's a snobby term that people apply to smart, well-crafted horror movies that critics take seriously. Movies just like His House. I won't use that term here, but I will call His House more measured and thoughtful than most other horror genre films. And those aren't terms you always associate with horror flicks, but there's no reason we shouldn't. Great films challenge the way you think about the world. You could walk away from this movie inspired to debate immigration policy or England's long history of colonialism.
but you could also spend the rest of the night talking about that terrifying sequence where a face looked out from inside a wall. The beauty of the film is in how well it works on so many levels. As much as I love this movie, I must admit it's not for everybody. This horror thriller is more likely to show up in arthouse cinemas than grindhouse theaters. It's quiet and subdued and open to more than one interpretation, and requires all your attention because Weekes doesn't always spell out what's happening to the characters. Horror fans who stand for movies with blood, guts, and high body counts may find this slow and dull, and if you're someone who scares easily, this movie will mess you up. I have no doubt his house is responsible for more than a few cases of night terrors. Consider yourself warned. Check out the trailer for a sense of whether or not you think you can handle this one. His House works as an enjoyable genre flick and as an astute social commentary. It's no surprise this picture has a 100% fresh score on Rotten Tomatoes right now. Focusing on two asylum seekers legally bound to live inside a haunted house is a fantastic premise. But a brilliant premise doesn't guarantee a brilliant movie, so credit goes to Weekes and his marvelous cast for delivering on the setup's promise. You can't expect much more from a debut feature, and I can't wait to see what Weekes does next. I'm reserving this outstanding horror thriller a spot on my best of the year list. If you'd like to support the film, head to Netflix and give it a stream, and make sure you spread the word on social media. It goes a long way in helping filmmakers continue to share their unique stories.
Thank you so much for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please hit the like button and press subscribe if you want to be in the loop on future videos. I've got more features, more reviews coming your way, as well as a profile on Sundance 2021. Going back to Sundance, y'all. Virtually. And to all my horror hounds, I want to know, what was the scariest movie you saw in 2020? Leave a comment down below. And please support Black cinema. Head over to Netflix and give His House a stream. Tell all your friends about it. Shout it out on social media. It goes a long way in helping dope Black filmmakers keep sharing their unique stories. Thanks for watching. One love.